What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Occult Gaming Channel with me, your host Bell Artwright, and today we are continuing the Chronicle mode for Undernight Inbirth EXE latest, and this is damn near a full year after the last episode I recorded of this. I think the last episode I recorded was back in July of 2019. It is now May of 2020, so as you can tell, my channel and my life has been kind of all over the place, but I've been looking forward to coming back to this because those episodes I made recording this were just so fun. So we're going to continue with Yuzuru Riha's story and chapter 2 of that story, so let's go ahead and get into it. She entered into the night. Deeper and thicker. And forgive me for forgetting some terms after darn near a year of inactivity with this story. But I'm gonna have to figure out the terminology pretty soon for this. So EXS, I remember, was the type of energy that not only inbirths used, but other types of folks used as well. But I think mostly inbirths used EXS, a kind of esper or psychic energy, if I remember correctly. I'm not entirely sure. I don't exactly know what that means, but I guess maybe we'll learn about that. Okay, it's because of the EXS that it looks hazy red like that. I wonder why. Guess she's wondering that too. Okay, so this is all coming from one particular person. It was funny, this is how I was feeling on the last episode. Because I was recording so late at night from, at the time I was staying with my family in an apartment building in a different city. But now I'm living on my own, so I'm able to record more frequently. But yeah, I was, I only had specific times I could record, and sometime it would be in the middle of the night, and sometime it'd be long marathon sessions over a couple of days because, you know, my family members were out of town or something. But yeah, we're getting right back into it. What she just said just reminded me of all those memories. But yeah, let's keep going. Okay, looks like we're approaching this character, this person. I don't really know what this means. I have to be aware of my surroundings. I shouldn't worry about that. So is it her emotions that's causing this? I don't know what this means at all, honestly. Okay, so she's just stumbled upon a fight. And wielders, I believe, are those who use EXS, or rather, I think inbirths are considered wielders. I'm not entirely sure. I can't remember. Oh, somebody got messed up.
そんなところで何やってるのさ。
I wonder, is this, are these gonna be two characters we know?
能力者なのは多分お互い様でしょうから置いとくとして。いい年下若者が浮かれて喧嘩なんかしてんじゃないっての。それ以上暴れようってんなら、私が相手になるよ。
So, wielders must be more prevalent than I thought, because, yeah, if random kids have these abilities, then it seems like it's kind of, in some ways, not mundane, but just more frequent than I was imagining it was. Kind of reminds me of Digimon, where there's this like underground society of, not even society, underground kind of collection of kids that have these abilities that, you know,They fight each other and all these things、without a certain segment of society knowing about it. Well, society at large knowing about it. I wonder how old these kids are.Elegant looking one. Is she talking about Akatsuki? Not Akatsuki, I'm sorry. Byakuya. The guy with the spider powers. Yeah, I'm thinking it's a Byakuya. Oh no, this is somebody completely new. So she considers him a kid? She must be in her mid-20s.
Booty Kotoba ni Kai Kotoba de ne. Soko de Taureter Yatsuga Karam de Chattesa. Sawagashi Katayonara, so it's why I am a Stemorao. Mochiro, Kochiranimo Kokishin to your Hinga Atano Mitomerana. Nazo Haru, Storix.
何をか私知らないし
Other characters Hold on a second Right. Yeah, so we have a bunch of new named characters who don't actually appear in the fighting portion of the game. So this is actually interesting to me.
Eh, yari sugi da to watashi wa sou itteita ita hazu.
Oi, 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 oi. Soko wa nakama toshite kabatte kurete ii in janai ka?
Nan nano koitsura?
Don't like the skinny macho boy. I wonder if these people. I wonder, are they gonna eventually be playable? What she was even doing here. Okay, there's newbies.
Hmm. 悪さしてるってわけではなさそう。場合によってはだけど。
Yeah, might as well. Cause what's there to gain from three newbies who barely know how to use their powers?
ともかく、こちらの言い分ってのはそういうことだ。 この場に何かルールでもあるなら以後注意するよ。
本当に？ま、嘘だろとまでは言わないけどさ、お天道様に誓える？
うん。OK。
ああ、本当だ。あのお天道様に誓うぜ。
ならま、仕方ないか。誰だって降りかかる火の粉を払う必要はあるしね。
うんうん、その通りだ。理解していただき光栄ですよ、お嬢さん。
で、あんた、オーガさんって言ったっけ？見たところ、あんたは初心者みたいだけどさ。
Yeah, they're playing that song I like so much. And, if you hear any background noise, my apologies. Got a bunch of neighbors active during the quarantine, so not gonna be able to control that. Seems from the looks of you, you're a newbie.
もっと親しげにオーガで構わないって、お嬢さん。できれば、あなたのお名前をお聞かせ願いたい。
I wonder what's up with this guy.
ここが真っ当なデートスポットとは思えない。
okay.
女の子連れてこんなところをお散歩なわけ。
Okay, so that's the, I was wondering, was, is that what he was going for? The compliments and stuff for him ingratiating himself upon her. I was wondering if that was due to him wanting an ally or, you know, or him trying to get a date. Looks like he's trying to get a date, or at least that's how she interpreted it.The music is too smooth. It wasn't quite right to say that they were used to it, but those two girls were pretty relaxed in such an eerie place.
Ah, 女性陣の片方がインバースとしての先輩でな。
Oh, okay.
夜を案内したいと言われ、好奇心から来てしまったというわけさ。で、あなたのお名前をお聞かせ。
Okay, so one of the girls.Has been around in-birth related events for quite some time, or at least longer than him. So that could range anywhere between maybe she was out for an additional night, or it could be even longer than that.
なるほどね。
I don't know if she really believes that. I don't know if I really believe that.
そしたらこれだ。夜と呼ばれる空間に立ち入ってすぐそこの男に絡まれて。ここは噂通り恐ろしいところだな。
He seems awfully
教えてくれない？
Awfully interested in her name. So I wonder, does that have some type of implication to where, you know how...Old world folklore had a lot of legends where if you gave somebody your name, that gave them some type of power over you, whether that be to curse you or any sort of other thing, to enchant you or whatever. It reminds me of how demons are handled in a lot of folklore, where if you know the demon's name, then that gives you power over that demon.But it was like that with humans too. Like if you know a human's name, you could be subjected, that human could be subjected to certain curses and things like that. So I wonder, does that have anything to do here, or if he's just genuinely interested in her name? Hopefully we'll find out. And these are her thoughts, I imagine.
何言ってんだか。恐ろしいなんて顔全くしてないでしょ、あんた。
そんなことないって顔に出ないだけだよ。信じてくれ、お嬢さん。
He's really smooth. I wonder too, is he a yakuza or anything like that? Due to how cool he dressed he is. How, his suit, it denotes somebody who's, really, kind of savvy when it comes to, you know, city activities, urban activities. So he's cool and calm, but has no charm? Hmm. Okay, so he seems to be pretty knowledgeable about EXS.
ま、相手の方も心配だし、一応確認しますか。
Okay, cool. We get to see who his opponents are. I'm guessing they're going to be faceless.We're not gonna see him on screen. Oh, damn, he knocked him back that far. Goodness. Okay, well, she did call him a playboy, so maybe he's just rich.
もしもし、もしもし、生きてる？お返事ください。はあ、まあダメか。もともと意識あるなら起きてくるだろうしね。ま、返答はないけど、ちゃんと息もしてるみたいだし、この程度なら放っておいても平気かな。男だし。
Yeah, fair enough.
能力者、生命力強いから大丈夫でしょう。
I wonder how they became wielders. I don't remember if they explained how people became wielders yet. It just seemed like some people have the gift and some people don't. I'm not sure if it works like maybe vampirism, like if you get hit by an ability or something like that, you're infected with EXS or something. Or in other shows or other bits of media, sometimes just experiencing like like in Hunter x Hunter, like if you get hit with a nin ability, if you have the capacity for it and some type of toughness and skill, you can actually unlock your nin that way. So I wonder, is it the same with EXS?So he's definitely smitten with Yuzuriha. Oh, really? I thought with her huge sword, something like that would be pretty much child's play. So now she's seeing their potential as enemies. So I don't know. You might just want to team up with them or get on their good side.
どうだった？名前教える気になってくれた？
はいはい、キャッカ。あっちのとこ、命はあるみたいだからいいけどさ、喧嘩も大概にすんだよ。あんたみたいなバカ力で殴ったら死んじゃうんだからね。
Now she's lecturing them.I wonder, is that going to be good enough for him? Doesn't seem like it would be. Seems like he's going to give her a little bit of trouble.
その点は反省してるって。な、紙くずみたいに飛んでいくとは思わなかったんだよ。今回で分かったから、次回からは加減していくぜ。
次回とか次次回とか悠長なこと言ってんじゃないの。こんなとこまだ来るつもりなの、あんたは。
Okay, there's a little bit of strife going on.
そりゃまた来るつもりさ。興味深い場所だからね。あなたのような綺麗な女性にも会えたし。
Oh, he's landed on thick now.
いくら興味があったって、こんなとこ危ないだけじゃん。子供じゃないんだからさ。大人は大人しくって、わかるでしょ。
Okay, he's an adult. So I wonder who she was referring to as kids. Was it just the girls and the people he was fighting? If so, why the hell is he fighting kids? Guess to learn how to use his powers.
まあ、そうだな。不気味な夜探検なんてそう何回も来ようってもんじゃないし。
That's gonna be a lie. 100%. He's coming back. 100%. If you find out you had superpowers and can blow people away with just a single punch, you wouldn't want to leave. You want to explore that power and see what you can do with it, because there's probably a lot more you can do with it. So he's 100% gonna be back.
なんだかよくわからないパワーってのも使ってみてわかった。喧嘩するだけじゃ大した面白みもないもんだしな。
でしょでしょ。
目的も果たしたし、今日のところはおとなしく帰るとしよう。一度帰って考えを整理する必要がある。二度と来ないって約束はまだできないけどな。
At least he's honest about it.
目的？
いや、そこは気にしなさんな。夜を見る。己の力を見てみる。それが目的だったんだ、今日は。
ああ。まあ、私は分かってくれりゃいいけど。みんな、あんたみたいに素直に帰ってくれると楽なんだけどね。
That's what I'm thinking is it's gonna be some type of bait and switch.
とにかく、私の目の黒いうちは、この辺で妙な喧嘩とか騒動はやめてよねってことでよろしく。分かったなら帰って、歯磨いて寝なさい。
The hell is the brush your teeth got to do with anything? That's a good tip, but why is she sounding like Captain Planet or something? She's kind of corny.
Ah, demo その前に俺の方も気になることができた。あなたがこの夜に詳しい方とお見受けして聞きたいことがあるんだが、いいかい？
何よ、名前とかくだらないこと以外なら答えるよ。
お嬢さんは随分と前からインバースとして生きてるんだよな。だからここのしきたりをご教示願おうとね。
OK, I mean that's fair enough.
ご教示？まあ確かにその通りだけど、人を年寄りみたいに言ってくれちゃって。
Well, how can he not when you were this whole time? You're acting like an elderly person. You're talking to him like you're a senior, basically. Talking down to him and giving him lectures. That's fair enough. He's fair enough to talk to her like that.
年寄りだなんてそんな言葉に配慮が足らずに申し訳ない。単純に先輩という話さ、お姉様。
Exactly. Fair enough.
そこの倒れた男たちにも聞いていたことなんだがね。わからないとかバカにするなとか、それで喧嘩になった。話のできる方から聞ければと思ったまでさ。
ああ、そうだったんだ。
Oh, okay. So is it... Does this have something to do with their mental faculties, or is it just they just really want to use their powers? Not sure.Okay, she goes into it more here, throwing some kind of high or something. I think if it had to do with being an inbirth, then she would know more about what that high was. But it sounds like she doesn't, so it may have something to do with something else. Or just me, it may just be pertaining to that particular person, how they react to having inbirth abilities on the Hollow Knight.
話が聞ければ素直に帰るし、今後を考える材料にもできる。お忙しい身だろうが、これも無用な騒動を減らすためってね。
確かに、冷静に考えると誰かに教えるって悪くないかもね。教育ってやつ、正しい知識が伝われば被害も減ったりしそうだし。
See, that right there is a double-edged sword, because teaching him to control his powers could, depending on his mentality, could reduce the amount of damage he does. But it also could give him greater control, and if he's a piece of shit, then yeah, you've helped in creating a potential problem in the future. So it's gonna be interesting to see how this goes. He seems like a pretty good lad so far, but he seems a little bit shady as well. Exactly.
話しにくいか。それなら場所を変えよう。本当はお嬢さんと一緒に紅茶でも楽しみたいが、そういう話題でもない。すぐ近くに広くて手頃な場所があるから、そっちへ行こう。
あら、察しがいい。それならオッケー。行きましょう。
ああ、お受けいただき光栄至極。お嬢さんのお肌が虫にでも刺されたりしたら嫌だしな。すぐそばの倉庫だ。この草木の多い路地より少しはマシだろ。
A freaking warehouse. All types of red flags are going off in my head. Luckily, Yuzuriha can defend herself, but a freaking warehouse, man. Come on. Come on. You're obviously up to no good. Okay. She doesn't know how to handle his compliments, his open charm.Screwing up my rhythm. Just full of himself. I don't quite know what she means here. I guess she's getting a little bit flustered by him. Maybe she's not used to hearing stuff like this.
ここに買っていないんだよね。
That's weird. No mosquitoes? then it is not silence. You're trying to make it into awkward silence, but He is not having it, I guess. Yeah, good idea. It's not good to be surrounded like that. So she's talking about the one with the glasses, looks like the fighter. This is all shady.Okay, well, I guess that's the end of that chapter. So that was fairly short. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here. And then next time we'll continue with the next chapter. Hope you guys are enjoying my revisit of Undernight in Birth EX Latest, the Chronicle Mode. I'm going to go ahead and try to finish this. So look forward to more episodes of this. It may take me some time to finish because I think I have a lot of characters.Have a lot more than last time, including Batista, Mika, Chaos, Carmine, Byakuya. At least they give us like a little taste of how many chapters each character has. Carmine has the most. Has just as many as Odia. But yeah, we're gonna finish up Yuzuriha and probably move on to Batista next and go from there. So.Appreciate you guys for stopping by. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Till next time, guys.